Hello students, myself Suraj Kumar Gupta, an assistant professor in mechanical engineering department at MLS. Previously we have done in the first lecture the basic concept of the power transmission. We have derived the formula for velocity ratio for simple belt drive in two cases, and we have done some numerical problem on velocity ratio. In second lecture we have derived the formula for total length of the belt in open belt drive, and we did some numerical problem on total length of belt in open belt drive. Now we are going to start the third lecture. In this we will study the formula for the total length of the cross belt drive, and we will understand the what is the tension in the belts, and we will derive the equation for tension ratio. But before that we have to see the formula for cross belt drive, which is almost same as open belt drive. There is only one difference is there. The in open belt drive here it is minus, and in case of cross belt drive this is plus. And in case of approximate length in open belt drive here it is minus, and in case of cross belt drive here it is plus. So we can see that the formula in open belt drive there is a minus, so the length is lesser than cross belt drive. So cross belt drive having the more length than open belt drive. We can see from the diagram that length must be greater than open belt drive because it is going crossly. So the length is more. So we can see the contact angle at both the drive means driver at driven, the contact angle is high, means theta 1 is also 180 plus 2 alpha means pi plus 2 alpha in radian, and theta 2 is also 180 plus 2 alpha, that is pi plus 2 alpha in radian. So you are going to solve the same problem with for the cross belt drive, and you make this tabular form solution. So you should write the exact length for the open belt drive and approximate length for the open belt drive, and for the same for the cross belt drive also, and you will conclude that the length for the cross belt drive is more than open belt drive, and the same will be uploaded on the Google classroom. So now the tensions. What is tension in the belt? We have to understand where the tension is high and where the tension is low. So there is a pulley with a friction. If it is not a frictionless, if it is a frictionless pulley, then the tension will be same at everywhere. But this is a type of pulley where the friction is there. So the tension is different for the this portion and this portion. So we can see that this pulley is run by motor, and this pulley is run by the motion of the belt. So the first the motor is starting started the this pulley, and this pulley will make this belt to move in this direction. In this direction, motion takes place in the belt, this belt will provide the motion to this driven pulley. So the tension is only decided by this driven pulley, because this driven pulley is rotated because of the belt, not driver pulley. Driver pulley is rotated because of motor. So the tension is here in this direction, the tension is more, and here it is less. So to understand is it clearly, as we should divide this figure in individual figure for the driver and for the driven in two parts. So we can see the direction of the tension. Tension is always away from the substance where it applies, and we should know that the tension is a type of force. So the tension is always away from the substance, because tension will created when the substance is in stretching, means if we pull the substance outside from the body, so the tension will create it. So here it is also away, here it is also away, but we have to decide where the tension is lesser and where it is higher. First of all, we should know that if the tension is high, then it is denoted by T1. If the tension is low, then that tension will be denoted by T2. The tension in the tight side and tension in the slack side. So T1 is greater than T2. So where it is T1 and where it is T2, if this is a driven pulley, the driven pulley is rotated because of the belt. So belt having, if we assume that there is a man who is pulling this belt in this direction, and another man is pulling this belt in this direction, but pulley is rotating in this direction, means this man is more powerful than this man. So the tension will be more in this direction. So this must be T1 and this must be T2. But this belt is connected with this portion. So here it is also T1 and here it is also T2. Now the we are going to derive the equation for the ratio of the tension. So first of all, this is a pulley and there is a belt in which there is a tension T1 and there is a tension T2, and we see the contact angle is theta. We are taking a small strip MN at angle d theta. So we are going to see that there is tension, and here it is also tension. Tension A, at A it is T2, at B it is T1. So tension is varying from T2 to T1 from A to B, and angle is 0 to theta. So the tension is here, it is more than T2 but less than the tension at N. Okay, and the tension is higher here, but here it is less, here it is more less, and here it is smallest. So we are going to start with this portion MN. So this portion is taking out, and we are going to draw the free body diagram for the same portion. So we can see that there is a normal reaction from the pulley to the belt, because this belt is pushing this pulley in downward direction. But then at the same time, the pulley will resist this pushing force and give normal reaction at upward direction. And we know that this belt is going in this direction, so there is a friction force which is in opposite direction of the motion. So if this MN is going trying to move in this direction, then friction will apply in the opposite direction. So this is N and this is mu N. This mu N is known as the friction force. We know that the friction force will be equals to the coefficient of friction multiplied by the normal reaction. And this is angle d theta, and the half of this is d theta by 2. So this line is perpendicular to this line, and we know that this radial direction is the perpendicular to the tangential direction. So if the angle is d theta by 2 here, so the angle between this line will also be d theta by 2, and the similar way this is also d theta by 2. And we can see that here it is tension T, so at N the tension must be more than this. So how much it is more? Angle is d theta, so if the tension is here is T, so tension here it is T plus dt. But when we applying the equilibrium equation to find some equations, so we have to resolve all the forces in horizontal and x vertical directions, but these forces are not in the vertical nor in horizontal direction. So we have to resolve this in the horizontal and vertical components. So what is the component in the with the theta? It is cos component. If the its component in the vertical direction, it is sine component. And the same way, this is sine component and here it is cos component. So we can see that the normal force is as it is and mu n is as it is, but the components are of this T is T cos d theta by 2 in the horizontal direction, and vertical direction T sin d theta by 2, and the same way the for T plus dt. So applying this summation of fx equals to 0, that is all the forces in x direction must be 0. The algebraic sum of the all the forces in x direction must be 0. That is all the forces in leftward equals to all the forces in rightward. So how many leftward forces? Mu n plus T cos d theta by 2, that will be equals to this value. And upward force is equals to n equals to this plus this. I'm going to apply these equations. Then we will have this equation mu n plus dt cos d theta by 2. Since d theta by 2 is a very small, so cos d theta by 2 can be taken as a unity, because if the angle is tends to 0, then cos 0 will be 1. So we have the equation mu n equals to dt, that is the equation number 1. And from the summation of fy, that is all the forces in upward direction will be equal to all the forces in downward direction. This is the downward direction forces and this is upward direction forces. So since d theta by 2 is a very small, so sine d theta by tends to d theta by 2, and we know that this is very small quantity and this is also very small quantity, so the product of the small quantities will vanish and we can neglect this to zero. So we applying these assumptions, we will have this equation n equals to t d theta. This is equation number 2. Putting these, solving these equations, we will have this equation mu t d theta equals to dt. Moving further, we should apply the integration in the both side. So for the variable theta, the angle is varying from 0 to theta and the tension is varying from t2 to t1. So what is the mu is the constant, so integration of d theta will be theta and limits are 0 to theta, and for 1 by t integration is ln of t, limits is t2 to t1, so ln t1 minus ln t2 equals to mu into theta. So we can apply law formulas, ln a minus ln b, that will be equals to ln of a by b. So here it is ln t1 by t2 equals to mu theta. Taking anti-log in both sides, t1 by t2 equals to e raised to power exponential to the power mu theta. So theta must be taken in radian here. Theta must be taken in radian, where theta is a angle of contact. And here it is the relation between the theta and alpha that we have done in the previous lecture. Only we have to take this alpha in equals to sine inverse in this equation r1 minus r2 by l for the open belt drive, and for cross belt drive it is sine inverse r1 plus r2 by l. This formula is used when we need to find the total length of the belt for exact formula. So now the ratio of the tension for the V belt drive and rope drive. So V belt drive is required to avoid the slipping of the belt from the pulley. So for this condition, we have to make a groove on the pulley, a V groove. This is known as a V groove type, and the belt is inserted in this groove so that there is no slipping in this directions. So there is a groove angle which is known as 2 beta. So groove angle is 2 beta. So beta is a semi groove angle. In the same case, the for the rope drive, the cross section of the rope, it is circular. So the groove angle is also 2 beta for that, and beta is a semi groove angle. In that case, the ratio of the tension will be e raised to mu theta divided by sine beta. So we have to remember this. This should be in the radian and this should be in degree, because this is the trigonometric function. Here it is not a trigonometric function.